It felt weird waking up without you.
Well, I couldn't stay. Not after you spat your dummy out.
Yeah, because the uncle of your unborn child will be the kid that raped me.
You can't seriously expect me to just turn me back on Sinead.
Right, OK, so in 5 years' time, when Finn's out of prison, it's Christmas time, we're just going to set another place at the table for him?
Of course not, you're being daft.
Oh, yeah, I'm being daft. I just need to man up, get a grip, stop wallowing in self-pity.
That's not fair. You know that I would never think that.
You have asked me to forgive you so many times. For the drugs, for cheating on me.
But you can't ask me to choose between you and my kid, right? Simple as.
Well, then I hope that you and Sinead are very happy together.
Josh, and don't go drizzling all your blood over my amuse-bouche.
Mum, what if Steve picks jump all over me and the baby? I don't think I can do it again, not on my own.
Do you never think that poor lad's got enough on his plate already?
What do you mean?
Oh, you know, just trouble in the house all over again.
Guys, what are you doing here? I'm trying to make a good impression.
Well, we just thought we'd come and show our support for our favourite cousin.
Nothing to do with the free bar, then?
No, of course not.
Look, just keep a low profile, yeah? I'm being interviewed later to get my old job back. Please, please don't mess this up for me.
Right. Chill out. Oh, I hate school. Do we have to be here?
Yes. Lockie wants to work on our day off. Well, at least he can do is fetch and carry for me.
Wherever he is. Oh. Really nice.
Hiya. Hiya. So you're working here tonight then, eh?
Yeah.
I'm sorry about trying to make you choose. It wasn't fair of me.
It's okay. If I was you, I'd be upset as well.
Talk about it later. I promise I won't throw my toys out of the pram or anything.
Okay, well, I'm going to hold you to that. Right, good luck.
Thanks.
Oi. I wonder what all these people would think if they knew you made Steve pick between you and his unborn baby.
Please. You wrecked your stepmom's marriage. Why would anybody listen to you?
You're just jealous. Because I want to share something more intimate with Steve than you ever could.
Listen to me, you little tot. Despite what you might think, this is a marriage that you can't destroy. But if you keep pushing, I'll make sure that you lose Steve for good. Do you understand me?
John Paul McQueen, this is Charles Cook, head of our Board of Governors.
Lovely to meet you.
You too. I've been looking at your dossier.
Oh,
very impressive.
Thank you very much.
Oh, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, lunch is about to be served, so would you like to take your seats?
Patrick, can I have a word about John Paul, please?
Well, I don't think he needs a character witness, Jeanette.
Do you know that he told the father of my unborn baby to abandon me? I mean, I know what he went through was horrible, and I know what you're going to say. I'm Finn's sister, but...
It sounds like a private matter. This is not the place.
OK, well, what about the fact that he beat up a pupil? Or are we all supposed to just forget about that?
Jeanette, what are you doing?
John Paul, are you all right?
Yeah.
And what about the fact that he spent a night in hospital for doing coke?
Yeah, I was spiked.
But you still bought it off him and you hoovered it right up, didn't you, eh?
Oi! My husband is not a drug dealer.
Okay, love.
Are you all right, love? I've just cut my finger on a glass.
Oh, excuse, let me see.
No, don't touch him. He's bleeding. Come
I
on.
Don't need any help. I can look after myself.
No, Sinead, he's got HIV. Oh.
What? Is it true?
I was going to tell you. For the record, Diane, it's not the plague. You can touch someone with HIV even if they've cut themselves.
Yeah, I know that. And I'm sorry, OK? I just panicked, because... Well, she cut her finger earlier.
Well, so you all knew about this?
See, I told her she has a right to know. Steve, I'm having your baby. When?
I met a guy a couple of months ago, so there's no chance of you being infected.
So have you got it?
No. No, I was given the all clear.
Well, at least that's something.
Is he gonna die?
No, look, people live with HIV for years now, don't they? It's not like he's gonna just keel over and abandon you.
Once again, Diane, well done for your sensitivity.
There you go.
Well done.
You! Outside! Now!
Sorry. I have to go.
Steve, wait!
John-Paul, I'm sorry it's not the best time, but there's been a change of plan. Panna would like to hold your interview now.
Steve, it's me. Where are you? Look, I need to know if you have something that belongs to me.
Just listen to me. I'm sorry that I didn't say anything, but Tony promised me not to.
You know how scared I was. I've already lost one baby.
I know that, but this baby is going to be fine, mate, because Steve's clear back then.
That is not the point. Right, one of you should have told me instead of all lying to me face.
Would you just walk away?
I need to go and get tested to be sure.
Right, well, let me come with you.
No? No way. If this proves anything, it proves that the only person I can truly rely on is me.
Great.
People on your side, you know. You have a good story, so don't be afraid to use it.
I'd hardly call being raped by a pupil in the school a good story, Patrick.
John-Paul, you're a good teacher. One that's being offered the chance to get your career back on track and provide security for your son. But all of that depends on what happens now in that room. So you ready?
Mr. Blake, shall we?
After you.
Patrick. Sorry, I've just got a text off Steve. I'll be 1 second. 1 second.
It's in there. You've got no idea how much I want it.
Come on, then. Pick a team.
You saw the way people have been looking at me today. Right, so I just need to have something to wipe it out.
I know you do, but I can't always be around.
I need you to help me. Right, where were you?
I was at my job interview. Where do you think I was? Is this payback? Because I made you choose between me and Sinead?
No. I think Sinead's already made her decision.
Right. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have put you in that position. But Steve, we can't live our lives like this. Scared that every time we have a bad day, we're going to end up back here.
Yeah, I know. I know, and I'm sorry. But I do love you.
I love you too. And I want to help you, but there's only so much that I can do. So, what do you want more? Me? Or the coke?
I want you.
We're gonna get through this. Okay, it's gonna be hard, but we're gonna get through it, I promise you. I'll get rid of them. Get rid of this. Okay?
Can I have a word, please?
Patrick, I'm sorry.
I put my reputation on the line for you and you just walked out. Job offers withdrawn.
This wasn't my fault. My husband needed me.
This was your chance, John-Paul.
Please, will you just listen to me?
I've made my decision. And don't waste any more of my time.
Did you get your job back then?
Yeah. Yeah, I start first thing on Monday.